Σήμερον σωτηρία το κόσμο γέγονε, άσομε το Αναστάντη εκ τάφου και αρχηγό τη ζωή ημών. Καθένον γαρ το θάνατο των θάνατων, τον οίκος εδωκέν ημίν και το μέγα ελεό.
Ευλογημένη Βασιλεία του Πατρός και του Υιού και του Άγιου Πνεύματος νυν και Άγιοι και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
Υπέρ της άνωθεν ειρηνίας και της σωτηρίας των ψυχών ημών του Κυρίου δεηθωμέν.
Κύριε ελέησον.
For peace in the whole world, for the stability of God's holy churches, and for the oneness of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
Υπέρ του Αγίου οίκου τούτου και του μεταπίστεως ευλαβίας και φοβεθεοίσιον τον εαυτό του Κυρίου δεηθωμέν.
Bishop Iacovos, the honorable priest of the deacons in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
Υπέρ του Αιού Θεού Σεβούς Πρόεδρου της χώρας ημών ταύτης, πάσης αρχής και εξουσίας και σύμπαντος του Αμερικανικού και Ελληνικού Έθνους, του Κυρίου δεηθωμέν.
For the city and parish, for every city and land, and for the faithful who live in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
Υπέρ ευκρασίας αέρων αφορίας των καρπών της γης και καιρών ειρηνικών του Κυρίου δεηθωμέν.
Those who travel by land, sea, and air, for those who are sick or suffering or in captivity, and for their safekeeping, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
Υπέρ του Ρησίνα ημάς από πάσης θρύψεως, οργής, κινδύνου και ανάγκης, του Κυρίου δεηθωμέν.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, in your grace.
Kyrie eleison.
Remember now, most holy, pure, blessed, glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints. Let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
Επίση πάσα δόξα, τιμή και προσκυνήσεις το Πατρί και του Υιό και του Άγιο Πνεύμα την ίν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Lord our God, whose dominion is inconceivable, whose glory is incomprehensible, whose mercy is infinite, whose love toward mankind is ineffable, do thou, my self, O Master, and the Lord, down upon us, and grant us and those who pray with us that have their mercies and confessions.
Amen.
ψυχή μου τον Κύριον και μη επιλανθάνουν πάσας τας ανταποδώσεις αυτού.
Τες πρεσβείες της Θεοτόκου σώτερ σώσον ημάς.
Κύριωσε το ουρανό, ετοίμασε τον θρόνον αυτού και η βασιλεία αυτού πάντων δεσπόζει.
Τες πρεσβείες της Θεοτόκου σώτερ σώσον ημάς.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, in your grace. Remembering our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos, and Ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another, the whole life to Christ our God. Yours is the dominion, and yours is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and always, and forever and ever.
Amen.
Master, Lord, our God, save thy people and bless thy inheritance. Protect the whole body of thy church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of thy temple. Do thou with the divine power, and forsake not us who set our power and our hope to thee. Thou hast given us grace at this time with one accord and
Σώσον ημάς, Ιε Θεού, ο Αναστάς εκ νεκρών, ψάλλοντας η Αλληλούια.
Βασιλέψει Κύριος στον αιώνα, ο Θεός του Σιών, εις γενεά και γενεά.
Σώσον ημάς, Ιε Θεού, Αναστάς εκ νεκρών, ψάλλοντας η Αλληλούια.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Άγιο Πνεύματι,
και νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Ο μονογενής Υιός και Λόγος του Θεού, αθάνατος υπάρχον και καταδεξαμένος διά την ημετέραν σωτηρίαν, σαρκωθήνε εκ της Αγίας Θεοτόκου και αη Παρθένου Μαρίας ατρέπτος εν ανθρωπίσας. Σταυρωθήστε Χριστέ ο Θεός, θανάτων, θάνατον πατή σας, ίσον της Αγίας Τριάδος, συνδοξαζόμενος το Πατρί και το Αγίο Πνεύματι, σώσον
έτσι και την ειρήνη του Κυρίου δαϊθωμέν. Αντιλαβούς όσων ελέησον και διαφυλάξον ημάς ο Θεός τη συγχωρητή. Της Παναγίας Ακράντου υπερευλογημένης εν δόξα δεσπίσιμον Θεοτόκου και αη Παρθένου Μαρίας με τα πάντων των Αγίων μνημονεύσαντες σε αυτούς και αλλήλους και πάσαν την ζωήν ημών. Χριστό το Θεό παραθωμεθόν. ούτε αγαθούς και φιλάνθρωπος Θεός υπάρχεις, και εσύ την δόξα να αναπέμπομεν, το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Άγιο Πνεύμα την ίν και αΐ, και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν. Αυτή η μέρα, Κυρίου, αγαλιασόμεθα και φρανθόμεν εν αυτή. Το φεδρόν της Αναστάσεως κήρυγμα εκ του Αγγέλου μαθούσεν εν του Κυρίου μαθήτριε και την προγονική απόφαση απορρίψασε της Αποστόλης καυχόμενε λέγον εσκύλευτε ο θάνατος ηγέρθη Χριστός ο Θεός δωρούμενος το κόσμο το μέγα έλεος.
Προσκυνήσομεν και προσπέσομεν Χριστό σώσον ημάς Ιε Θεό ο Αναστός εκ νεκρό. Αναστάσεως κήρυγμα εκ του Αγγέλου μαθούσε του Κυρίου μαθήτρια και την προγονικήν απόφαση να απορρίψασε της Αποστόλης καυχόμενε λέγον εσκύλευτε ο θάνατος ηγέρθη Χριστός ο Θεός δωρούμενος το κόσμο το μέγα έλεος.
Ετοιμάζου Βηθλέμ τη νύχτε πάσιν ιεδε ευτρεπίζου Εφραθά ότι το ξύλον τη ζωή εν το σπηλαίο εξήνθησεν εκ της Παρθένου. Παράδεισος και γα η εκείνης γαστή εδείχθη νοητός ενώ το θείον φυτόν εξού φαγόντε ζήσομεν ούχι δέος ο Αδάμπτεν θνίξομεθα. Χριστός γεννάτε την πρυπεσούσαν αναστήσον εικόνα μεγάλα
τα της πίστεως κατορθώματα εν τη πηγή της φλογός εξεπίδατος αναπαύσεως οι Άγιοι τρεις παιδες ηγάλωνο και ο προφήτης Δανιήλ λέοντον ποιμήν ως πρόβατον εδείκνητο τες αυτόν ηκεσίες Χριστέ ο Θεός σώσοντας ψυχάς ημών.
Ότι των μαρτύρων της Χριστίας διακονήσας. Μαρτυρικός εμιμήσοντας αρεστίας αυτών, διαθλήσεως εχθρών καταπαλέσασα. Όθεν βλιστάνεις δαφύλος χάριν αυθωρον αΐ Θεού φρον Αναστασία. Της προσιούς συνεκπόθω τη αραγή της προστασίας σου.
Μνήσθητε η Κύριε ως αγαθός των δούλων σου και όσα εν βίω ημαρτών συγχωρήστον που δυσγαράν αμάρτητος ημισιώδυναμε και της μεταστάσει δούνε την αγαπάση.
Εν τη γεννήσει την παρθενία ανεφύλαξας, εν τη κοιμήσει των κόσμων που κατέλειπες Θεοτόκε, μετέστης προς την ζωήν μητήρ υπάρχουσα της ζωής και τες πρεσβείες τες εσλυτρουμένη εκ θανάτου τας φτυχάσιμον.
Υπάρθενος ημέρων των προαιωνίων λόγων
εν σπηλέ
to the Lord.
For thou, God, art holy, and to thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Agios, O Theos,
set it from the impression of your voice. Worship our Lord, whose might have been thou, whose commandment was in our own image and likeness. Christ adorn him with all thy favors, thou who hast subjected wisdom and prudence. If not, we might receive it without suffering repentance or the salvation. Who hast accounted us thy humble and unworthy servants, worthy now to stand at this time before the glory of thy holy altar and to bring to thee adoration and praise, do thou, accepting the mouth of us sinners of thy holy voice, the righteous forgives all transgressions of all time and voluntary.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Άγιο Πνεύματι.
Και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν.
Άγιος αθάνατος.
Αλλά καθαρά τον Απόστολο, μην διάθεσε.
Σοφία
προς Εβραίους επιστολής Παύλου το ανάγνωσμα
προσχομέν.
Αδελφοί, πίστη παρώτησεν Αβραάμ εις την γήν της Επαγγελίας ως αλωτρίαν, εν σχοινές κατοικίσας μετά Ισάκ και Ιακώβ, των συγκληρονόμων της Επαγγελίας της αυτής. Εξεδέχεται ο γάρ τίν τους θεμελίους έχουσαν πόλην, εις τεχνίτης και δημιουργός ο Θεός. Και τι έτσι λέγω, επιλείψει γάρ με διηγούμενον ο χρόνος περί Γεδεών, Βαράκ τέτοια Σαμσόν και Ιεφθάε, Δαβίδ τέτοια Σαμουήλ και των προφητών, οι διαπίστεως κατηγονήσαντο βασιλείας, ηργάσαντο δικαιοσύνην, επέτυχον επαγγελιών, έφραξαν στόματα λεόντων, έσβεσαν δύναμην πυρός, έφυγον στόματα μαχαίρας, ενεδυναμώθησαν από ασθενείας, εγεννήθησαν ισχυροί εν πολέμο, παρεμβολάς έκλειναν αλωτρίων. Έλαβον γυναίκες εξ αναστάσεως τους νεκρούς αυτών. Άλλοι δε εντυμπανίστησαν ού προσεξάμενοι την απολύτρωσιν, ειν ακρίτωνος αναστάσεως τείχωσιν. Έτριδε δε εμπεγμών και μαστίγων πήραν έλαβον, έτι δε δεσμών και φυλακής. Ελιθάστησαν, επρίστησαν, επειράστησαν, εν φόνο μαχαίρας απέθωνον, περιήλθον εμιλωτές εν αγίης δέρμασιν, ιστερούμενοι, θλιβόμενοι, κακοχούμενοι, ονούκιν άξιος ο κόσμος, εν ερημίες πλανόμενοι και όρεση, και σπηλαίης και τεσοπές της γης. Και ούτι πάντες μαρτυρηθέντες δια της πίστεως, ουκ εκομίσαντο την επαγγελίαν του Θεού, ημών κριτών τη προβλεψαμένου, ή να μη χωρίσιμων τελειωθώσει.
Let us be attentive.
O God, we have heard with our ears the righteous cried, and the Lord heard them. Blessed are you, O Lord, the God of our fathers, for you are just in all you have done.
Wisdom.
The reading is from St. Paul's letter to the Hebrews.
Let us be attentive.
Brethren, by faith Abraham sojourned in the land of promise, and as in a foreign land, living in tents with Isaac and Jacob, heirs with him of the same promise. For he looked forward to the city which has foundations, whose builder and maker is God. And what more shall I say? For time would fail me to tell of Gideon, Barak, Samson, Jephthah, of David and Samuel, and the prophets, who through faith conquered kingdoms, enforced justice, received promises, stopped the mouths of lions, quenched raging fire, escaped the edge of the sword, won strength out of weakness, became mighty in war, put foreign armies to flight. Women received their dead by resurrection. Some were tortured, refusing to accept release, that they might rise again to a better life. Others suffered mocking and scourging, and even chains and imprisonment. They were stoned, they were sawn in two, they were tempted, they were killed by the sword. They went about in skins of sheep and goats, destitute, afflicted, ill-treated, of whom the world was not worthy. Wandering over deserts and mountains and in dens and caves of the earth. And all these, though well attested by their faith, did not receive what was promised, since God had foreseen something better for us, that apart from us, they should not be made perfect.
Peace be with you, the reader.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia,
alleluia. Sophia Orthia, Cusumendo Evangelio, Irini Passi. Εκτούκαν ο Ματθαίον Αγίου Ευγενείου του Ανάγνωσμα.
Πρόσχαμε.
Δόξα σοι, Κύριε, δόξα σοι.
Βίβλος γενέσεως Ιησού Χριστού, Ιού Δαβίδ, Ιού Αβραάμ. Αβραάμ εγέννησε τον Ισάκ, Ισάκ δε γέννησε τον Ιακώβ, Ιακώβ δε γέννησε τον Ιούδαν και τους αδελφούς αυτού. Ιούδας δε γέννησε τον Φαρές και τον Ζαρά εκ των Θάμαρ. Φαρές δε γέννησε τον Εσρόμ. Εσρόμ δε γέννησε τον Αράμ. Αράμ δε γέννησε τον Αμιναδάβ. Αμιναδάβ δε γέννησε τον Ασόν. Νασόν δε γέννησε τον Σαλμόν. Σαλμόν δε γέννησε τον Βοός εκ της Ραχάβ. Βοός δε γέννησε τον Οβίδ εκ της Ρούθ, Οβίδ δε γέννησε τον Ιεσέ, Ιεσέ δε γέννησε τον Δαβίδ τον βασιλέα. Δαβίδ δε ο βασιλεύς εγέννησε τον Σολομώντα εκ του Ροίου, Σολομών δε γέννησε τον Ροβοάμ, Ροβοάμ δε γέννησε τον Αβιά, Αβιά δε γέννησε τον Ασά, Ασά δε γέννησε τον Ιωσαφάτ, Ιωσαφάτ δε γέννησε τον Ιωράμ, Ιωράμ δε γέννησε τον Οζίαν, Οζίας δε γέννησε τον Ιωάθαμ, Ιωάθαμ δε γέννησε τον Αχάζ, Αχάζ δε γέννησε τον Ιζεκίαν, Ιζεκίας δε γέννησε τον Μανασί, Μανασίς δε γέννησε τον Αμών. Αμών δε γέννησε τον Ιωσίαν, Ιωσίας δε γέννησε τον Ιωχονίαν και τους αδελφούς αυτού επί της μετακεσίας Βαβυλώνος. Μετά την δε μετακεσίαν Βαβυλώνος, Ιεχονίας δε γέννησε τον Σαλαθιήλ, Σαλαθιήλ δε γέννησε τον Ζωροβάβελ, Ζωροβάβελ δε γέννησε τον Αβιούδ, Αβιούδ δε γέννησε τον Ιελιακήμ, Ιελιακήμ δε γέννησε τον Αζόρ, Αζόρ δε γέννησε τον Σαδάκ, Σαδάκ δε γέννησε τον Αχίμ, Αχίμ δε γέννησε τον Ελιούδ, Ελιούδ δε γέννησε τον Ελιάζαρ, Ελιάζαρ δε γέννησε τον Ματθάν, Ματθάν δε γέννησε τον Ιακώβ, Ιακώβ δε γέννησε τον Ιωσήφ, τον άντρα Μαρίας, εξ εις εγεννήθη Ιησούς ελεγόμενος Χριστός. Πάσε ουν εγενεία από Αβραάμ έως Δαβίδ, γενεία 14, και από Δαβίδ έως της μετεκεσίας Βαβυλώνος, γενεία 14, και από της μετεκεσίας Βαβυλώνος έως του Χριστού, γενεία 14. Του δε Ιησού Χριστού η γέννησης ούτως ειν. Μυστευθύσεις γάρ της μητρός αυτού Μαρίας, το Ιωσήφ πριν εισενελθήν αυτούς ευρέθη εν γαστρή, έχωσε εκ πνεύματος Αγίου. Ιωσήφ δε ο ανήρ αυτής, δίκαιος ον και μη θέλων αυτήν παραδειγματίσε, ευουλήθη λάθρα απολύσε αυτήν. Ταύτα δε αυτού, έθι μυθέντος ιδού άγγελος Κυρίου κατ όναρ εφάνει αυτό λέγον Ιωσήφ, Υιός Δαβίδ και φοβηθείς παραλαβήν Μαριάμ δε γενέκα σου, το γάρ εν αυτή γεννηθέν εκ πνεύματος έστιν Αγίου, τέξετε διόν και καλέσεις το όνομα αυτού Ιησούν. Ούτως γάρ σώσει των λαών αυτού από των αμαρτίων αυτών. Τούτο δε όλων γέγονον είναι πληρωθεί το ρίθεν υπό του Κυρίου, διά του προφήτου λέγοντος, ιδού η Παρθένος εν γαστρή έξι και τέξετε ιών και καλέσωση το όνομα αυτού Εμμανουήλ, ο έστι μέρθε μηνευόμενον με θυμών ο Θεός. Διεγερθείς δε ο Ιησούς από τον ύπνο επίησεν όσε προσέταξεν αυτό ο άγγελος Κυρίου και παρέλαβε την γενέκα αυτού και ουκ επίγνωκεν αυτό έως ου έτεκε τον Υιόν αυτής τον πρωτότοκο. Και ακάλεσε το όνομα αυτού Ιησού
The reading is taken from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. Let us be attentive. The book of the genealogy of Jesus Christ, the son of David, the son of Abraham. Abraham was the father of Isaac, and Isaac the father of Jacob, and Jacob the father of Judah and his brothers, and Judah the father of Perez, and Zerah the Tamar, and Perez the father of Hezron, and Hezron the father of Ram, and Ram the father of Aminabed, and Aminabed the father of Nasham, and Nasham the father of Salmon, and Salmon the father of Boaz by Rahab, and Boaz the father of Obed by Ruth, and Obed the father of Jesse, and Jesse the father of David the king. And David was the father of Solomon by the wife of Uriah, and Solomon the father of Rehoboam, and Rehoboam the father of Abijah, and Abijah the father of Asa, and Asa the father of Jehoshaphat, and Jehoshaphat the father of Joram, and Joram the father of Uzziah, and Uzziah the father of Jotham, and Jotham the father of Ahaz, and Ahaz the father of Hezekiah, and Hezekiah the father of Manasseh, and Manasseh the father of Amos, and Amos the father of Josiah, and Josiah the father of Jeconiah and his brothers, at the time of the deportation to Babylon. And after the deportation to Babylon, Jeconiah was the father of Shealtiel, and Shealtiel the father of Zerubbabel, and Zerubbabel the father of Abiud, and Abiud the father of Eliakim, and Eliakim the father of Azor, and Azor the father of Zadok, and Zadok the father of Achim, and Achim the father of Eliad, and Eliad the father of Eliezer, and Eliezer the father of Matthan, and Matthan the father of Jacob, and Jacob the father of Joseph, the husband of Mary, of whom Jesus was born, who is called Christ. So all the generations from Abraham to David were 14 generations, and from David, the deportation of Babylon, 14 generations, and from the deportation of Babylon to the Christ, 14 generations. Now the birth of Jesus Christ took place in this way. When the mother Mary had been betrothed to Joseph. Before they came together, she was found to be with child of the Holy Spirit. And her husband Joseph, being a just man and unwilling to put her to shame, resolved to divorce her quietly. But as he considered this, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not fear to take Mary to your wife, for which she is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had spoken by the prophet. Behold, a virgin shall conceive, will bear a son, and his name shall be called Emmanuel, which means God with us. When Joseph woke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took his wife, but he knew not until she had borne a son. And he called his name Jesus.
Δόξα σοι, Κύριε, δόξα.
Being ever protected by thy power, to thee we may ascribe glory, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Desires and pleasures of the flesh is worthy to approach or draw near, or to serve thee, O King of glory. For to serve thee is great and awesome even to the heavenly powers. Yet through thine ineffable and boundless love toward mankind, thou didst unchangeably and immutably become man and served as our high priest. As Lord of all, is committed to us the celebration of the liturgical blood and the sacrifice. For thou alone, our Lord, our God, rulest over all things in heaven and earth, who art born under the throne of the cherubim, and our Lord of the seraphim, and King of Israel, who alone art holy and rests among thy saints. Wherefore I implore thee, who alone art good and ready to listen, look down upon me, thy sinful and unprofitable servant. Look down upon me, thy, and cleanse my soul and my heart from evil conscience, and enable me with the power of the Holy Spirit, by some of the grace of the priesthood. Stand before this thy holy altar and consecrate thy immaculate body and precious blood. For to thee I come, having bowed my head, and beseech thee, turn not thy face away from me, neither reject from among thy children, but make me worthy, sinful, and worthy servant to offer these gifts unto thee. For thou art the offering, accept and distributed, O Christ our God, and to describe glory, together with eternal Father and thy holy life and spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Η τα χειροβήμη τη προσεγγίζονε και τη ζωή του Τριάδη, τη Μεσάγειο, οι προσάδοντε, πάσαν την βιβλιοτική που θα.
Ω το βασίλειο, ο Λεξόμεν τέσσερα και ο Ράτο, ο Φρούμενο, τάξη είναι αλλιώ.
Άδειο του Τριζάγιου πράσινε, πάσαν την βιωτική παθόρη μέρη μου.
Ω το βασίλειο, ο Λεξόμεν τέσσερα και ο Ράτο, ο Φρούμενο, τάξη είναι αλλιώ.
Ή τα χειροβήμη στι κοσμονίζοντε και τη οποία τριάδη του Χρυσάγιου νύμνου προσάδοντε πάσαν την ποιοτική να παθαρημένη μου.
Όσο μα εδώ εξώμα και συγκέντρωσε ο Ράτο, θα φύγει τάξη.
Θεός λάστιμη την καθαρίζω. Ο Θεός λάστιμη την καθαρίζω. Ο Θεός λάστιμη την καθαρίζω.
Βασιλεία αυτού πάντοτε νικαίει και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
May the Lord our God remember us all. To the ages of ages.
Συρωσύν σου μισθή, Κύριος ο Θεός, εν τη Βασιλεία αυτού πάντοτε νίκαιει και στους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν.
For the precious gifts here presented, let us pray to the Lord. Σώσον ελέησον και διαφύλαξον ημάς ο Θεός της η χάριτη.
Κύριε ελέησον.
Την ημέραν πασαν τελείαν Αγίαν ειρηνικήν και να μαρτητών παρά του Κυρίου ετησόμεθος.
Angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord.
Arashu Kyrie.
Sign νόμιν και αφέσιν των αμαρτιών και των πλημελημάτων ημών, παρά του Κυρίου ετησόμεθα.
Παράσχουν, Κύριε.
For all that is good and profitable for our souls and for peace in the world, let us ask of the Lord.
Τον υπόλοιπον χρόνον της ζωής ημών, εν ειρήνη και μετανοία εκτελέσε. Παρά του Κυρίου ετησόμεθα.
Πάσχου, Κύριε.
For Christian and to our lives, peaceful, free of shame and suffering, and for a good defense before the dreadful judgment seat of Christ, let us ask.
Παράσχου, Κύριε.
Στις Παναγίας Αχράνου υπερευλογημένης εν δόξου δεσποίνης ημών Θεοτόκου και υπαρθένου Μαρίας και τα πάντα των Αγίων μνημονεύσαντες αυτούς και αλληλούς πάσαν την ζωήν ημών Χριστό το Θεό παραθόμεθα.
Διό του νυκτυρμών του μονογενού σου Υιού μεθου ευλογήτως Υ, συν το Παναγίο και αγαθό και ζωπιό σου πνεύματι, νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Let us love one another, that with one mind we may confess.
Agapistos
Στήρας εν σοφία πρόσωμεν.
Πιστεύω εις ένα Θεό, Πατέρα Παντοκράτορα, ποιητήν ουρανού και γης, ορατώνται πάντων και αοράτων, και εις ένα Κύριον Ιησούν Χριστόν, τον Υιόν του Θεού τον μονογενή, τον εκ του Πατρός γεννηθέντα προπάντων των αιώνων, φως εκ φωτός, Θεόν αληθινών εκ Θεού αληθινού, γεννηθέντα, ουποιηθέντα, ομοούσιον το Πατρίδιου τα πάντα ηγένετο. Τον διημάς τους ανθρώπους και δια την ημετέραν σωτηρίαν, κατελθόντα εκ των ουρανών, εσαρκωθέντα εκ Πνεύματος Αγίου και Μαρίας Παρθένου και ανθρωπίσαντα, σταυρωθέντα τα υπέρ ημών, επί ποντίου Πιλάτου και παθώντα και τα φέντα, και αναστάντα τη τρίτη ημέρα κατά τας γραφάς. Και ανελθόντα εις τους ουρανούς και καθεζόμενον εκ δεξιών του Πατρός και πάλι ερχόμενον με τα δόξης, κρίνε ζώντας και νεκρούς, ού της βασιλείας, ού και στε τέλος. Και εις το Πνεύμα το Άγιον, το Κύριον, το Ζωοποιόν, το εκ του Πατρός εκπαιρευόμενον, το Συν Πατρί και Υιό συμπροσκυνούμενον και συνδοξαζόμενον, το λαλήσαν διά των προφητών, εις μίαν Αγίαν, καθολικήν και αποστολικήν εκκλησία, ομολογώ εν βάπτισμα εις άφεσιν αμαρτιών, προσδοκώ ανάσταση νεκρών και ζωήν του μέλλοντος αιώνος. Αμήν.
I believe in one God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages, Light of light, true God of true God, begotten, not created, of one essence with the Father, through whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary and became man. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate and suffered and was buried, and he rose on the third day according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come again with glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the Creator of life, who proceeds from the Father, who together with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who spoke through the prophets. In one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church, I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come.
Amen. Στάμε με τα φόβο, πρόσχομεν την Αγίαν Ανοφαράν, εν ειρήνη προσφέρειν.
Ελέον ειρήνης, Ιησού ανένεσεως.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God the Father, the communion of the Holy Spirit, be with you all. Let us lift up our hearts. To the Lord.
Τον επινικιόν ύμνον άβοντα βόντα και κραγόντα και λέγοντα.
Αγίος, Αγίος, Αγίος Κύριος Σαββαώθ, πλήρης ο ουρανός και η γη της δόξης σου, Ωσάνα εν της ύψης.
Master, who blessed mankind, we also pray all men and women, the only begotten Son, the Lord, 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 the surrendered himself for the life of the world. Having taken bread in his holy and immaculate and blameless hands, and thanked and blessed and sanctified and broken it, he gave to his holy disciples and apostles, saying,
Λάβετε, φάγετε, τούτο εστί το σώμα του επερήμων κολλούμενον εις άφεσιν αμάρτιον. Take ye, this is my body, which for you is broken unto remission of sins.
Likewise the cup after the supper, saying,
Ιωτ εξ αυτού πάντες, τούτο εστί το αίμα μου, το της γενιής διαθήκης, το επέρημον και πλών ευχηνωμένον, εις άφεσιν αμαρτιών. Drink from it, ye all. This is my blood of the New Testament, which for you and for many is shed, unto remission of sins.
Therefore, remembering this command of our Savior and all that he endured for us, the cross, the tomb, the resurrection, the third day, the ascension into heaven, the city of the right hand, the second and glorious coming again.
Amen. προσφέρομεν κατά πάντα και δια πάντα.
And we offer to thee this rational and bloodless worship. And we beseech thee and pray and supplicate thee, send down thy Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts here presented. Make this bread the precious body of thy Christ.
Amen.
And that which is in this cup the precious blood of thy Christ.
Amen.
Changing them by the descent of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May be to those who receive them for the purification of the soul, for the remission of sins, for the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, for the fulfillment of the kingdom of heaven, and for the boldness to approach thee, neither unto judgment nor unto condemnation. Again, we offer unto thee this reasonable worship for those who have fallen asleep in the faith, forefathers, fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, ascetics, and every righteous spirit made perfect in faith. Γιατί δεν θα ήθελα να πάω σε αυτό το σπίτι, να σου δημοσταίνω ταινίε. Βασιλείου, Παρασκευή Γεωργίου, Βασιλείου. Η Κατερίνη Ιανούλα. Γεωργίου, Κατερίνη. Και να πάω σε κάποιον πρόσωπο σου.
Ο κύριο Νάση. Ο κύριο Νάση.
Εξαιρετό.
Εξαιρετός εις Παναγίας Αχράνου επερευλογημένης εν δόξου Δεσποίνης ημών Θεοτόκου και η Παρθένου Μαρίας.
Αξίων εστίν ως αμύθος μακάρι.
Μίστητη Κύριε του Αρχιεπισκόπου και Πατρός ημών Ιακώβου, ον χάρις Αγίας Εκκλησίας εν ειρήνη, σον εν ημονία με εκμερεύοντα και ορθοτομούντα των λόγων της εις αληθείας.
Και ον εκαστός κάθε διάνοιαν έχει και πάντων και πασών.
Νόμος και δικαίων πάσα πληθείς, άμα Πατριάρχε και Προφήτε συν γυναίξη, τες Θεοτιμήτης βλέποντες κυρτώσιν, εν βυθέμ την πόλη Χριστόν τικτωμένον.
grant that with one voice and one heart we may glorify and praise your most exalted and majestical name, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and always and forever and ever.
In the mercies of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, shall be with you all.
Genetanto pneumaton su.
Having remembered all the saints again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the precious gifts here offered and consecrated, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
That our loving God, having accepted them at his holy and mystical altar in heaven as an offering of spiritual fragrance, will in turn send down upon us divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit, let us pray.
Kyrie.
Τα της πίστεως και την κοινωνία του Αγίου Πνεύματος σε τις άμενοι αυτούς και αλλήλους και πάσαν την ζωή ημών Χριστό το Θεό παραθούμεθο.
Καταξίωσον ημάς Δέσποτα με τα παρησίες εγκατοικρήτω στο μάλι επικαλείσαι των ομποράνιων Θεών Πατέρα και λέγειν.
Πάτρι μόν, ο εντής ουρανής, αγιαστήτω το όνομά σου, έλθε το η βασιλεία σου, γεννηθήτω το θέλημά σου, ως εν ουρανό και επί της γης, των άρτων ημών των επίουσιων, δώσι μην σήμερον και άφεσι μην τα οφειλήματα ημών, ως και εμείς αφήμεν σε φιλέτης ημών, και εμείς εν έγκυς ημάς πειρασμών, αλλά ρίσσε ημάς από το πονηρού. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
for yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and to the ages of ages.
Ειρήνη πάση
εν το πνεύμα της σου.
Τας κεφαλάς ημών του Κύριου κλείνομεν. Χάριτι και εκτιμής και φιλανθρωπία του μονογενού σου Υιού Μεθού ευλογητώσει, συν του Παναγίου και αγαθό και ζώπιο σου πνεύματι, νικαίαι και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Προσχομέν
το Αγία της Αγίης.
Μιλίζεται και διμερίζεται ο μνός του Θεού μιλιζόμενος. Δρούμενος απάντητε αισθιόμενος και μηδέποτε δρόμενος. Χριστιόντος αγιάζουν. Πλήρωμα ποτηρίου πίστιος πνεύματος Αγίου. Ζέσεις πίστης πλήρης πνεύματος Αγίου.
I believe, O Lord, and I confess that thou art verily the Christ, the Son of the living God, who didst come into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the first. Also, I believe that this is thy sacred body, and this thy precious blood. Therefore, I pray to thee, have mercy on me and pardon my transgressions, voluntary and involuntary, in word and deed, both known and unknown, and make me worthy to partake of thy sacred mysteries, unto the remission of sins and unto life eternal. Amen. Behold, I approach for Holy Communion, O Creator, burn me not as I partake, for thou art fire which burns the unworthy, wherefore do thou cleanse me from every stain. Receive me today, O Son of God, as a partaker of thy mystical feast. For I will not speak of the mystery to thine enemies, I will not kiss thee as did Judas, but as a thief I will confess thee. Lord, remember me when thou comest in thy kingdom. Tremble, O mortal, beholding the divine blood, for it is as a lighted coal burning the unworthy. It is God's body, and deifieth and nourisheth me. It deifieth my soul, and wondrously nourisheth my mind. Thou hast smitten me with yearning, O Christ, and with a divine love thou hast changed me. But do thou burn away with spiritual fire my sins, and make me worthy to be filled with the joy of thee, that rejoicing in thy goodness I may magnify thy two presences. Into the magnificence of thy saints, how shall I, the unworthy, enter? For should I also dare to enter the festal chamber, my robe betrays me, for it is not a festal garment, and I shall be bound and cast out by the angels. Cleanse my soul, O Lord, from pollution, and by thy compassion save me. O merciful Master, Lord Jesus Christ, my God, let not these holy gifts be unto me for judgment through my unworthiness, but rather for the purification and sanctification of my soul and body, and as an earnest of the life and kingdom to come. For it is good for me to cleave unto God and to place in the Lord hope of my salvation. Receive me today, O Son of God, as a partaker of thy mystical feast. For I will not speak of the mystery to thine enemies. I will not kiss thee as did Judas, but as the thief I confess thee. Lord, remember me when thou comest in thy kingdom. Tu dipnus ut mysticu simeron ietheu kinon omen paralabe. Umig artis ectrisu to mysterion ipo, u filima sidolso cathapero iudas, aloso distisum ologosi, nisitimu Kyrie and di basilia su, nisitimu despota and di basilia su, nisitimu Agie and di basilia su.
Ευλογή ψυχή μου τον Κύριον, ευλογητός η Κύριε, ευλογή η ψυχή μου των Κύριων και πάντα τα εντός μου το όνομα του Άγιον αυτού.
Ευλογή η ψυχή μου των Κύριων και μη επιλανθάνου φάσας τα σάντα αποδόσεις αυτού.
Φιλατεύοντα πάσας τα σαν ομοία σου, πόσος τα νόσους,
των λυτρούμενων εκ τώρα στην ζωή σου, των στεφανούντας εν ελέη και ηκτηρή.
Τον επιπλώντα εν αγαθή στην επιθυμίαν σου, ανακαινίσθησε το εσαετό η νεότη σου.
Τα φόβου Θεού πίσεως και αγάπης προσέλθετε.
Με τον Ευάγγελο δούλος του Θεού, Νικόλαος, εισάφησε μας αιών και ζωήν, αιών αιών, αμήν. Άγιο δούλος του Θεού, Ιωάννης, εισάφησε μας αιών και ζωήν, αιών αιών, αμήν. Με τον Ευάγγελο δούλος του Θεού, Γεωργία, εισάφησε μας αιών και ζωήν, αιών αιών, αμήν. Servant of God,
servant of God,
is commanded for the mission of his sins. The one you need to say, help your condemner, help your condemner. Come closer. Put your hand on his back and push them forward. Servant of God, the remission of our sins and the life everlasting. Servant of God, Marika, the remission of our sins and the life everlasting. Servant of God, the remission of his sins and for life everlasting. Please come closer. Maybe you need to stand further apart so that the people have room to come in. Just make sure they're close. Servant of God, Ioannis, Of his sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, let's come in for the mission of our sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God,
let's come in for the mission of our sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, let's come in for the mission of our sins and for life everlasting.
ότι πνεύμα διήλθεν εν αυτού και ούχ υπάρξει και ούχ επιγνώσετε έτσι τον τόπον αυτού.
Ο δούλος του Θεού.
Σάφησε Ματιών και ζωή.
Ο θέλεος του Κυρίου από του αιώνος και του αιώνος επί τους φοβουμένους αυτός.
Servant of God, mission for the mission of sin, for life everlasting. Servant of God, for the mission of sin, for life everlasting.
Servant of God,
Servant of God,
Servant of God, Servant of God,
Servant of God, τον θρόνο αυτού και η βασιλεία αυτού πάντων δεσπόζει.
Ευλογείτε τον Κύριον πάντες οι άγγελοι αυτού, δυνατοί ισχύ ποιούντες των λόγων αυτού, του ακούσε της φωνής των λόγων αυτού.
Ευλογείτε τον Κύριον φάση δυνάμεις αυτού,
Servant of God, let's come in for the mission of the saints. Servant of God,
good job, Christian.
Servant of God, let's come in for the mission of the saints, for life everlasting.
Σώσον ο Θεός το λαόν σου και ευλόγησον την κληρονομία σου.
Είδομεν το φως το αληθινόν, ελάβομεν πνεύμα εκ ουράνιον, εύρομεν πίστην αληθή, αδιαίρετον τριάδα προσκυνού. Αυτή γάρη μας έσωσε.
Πάντοτε νικαίοι και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Let us rise, having partaken of the divine, holy, pure, immortal, heavenly life, given in awesome mysteries of Christ. Worthily let us give thanks unto the Lord.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, in your grace. Heaven ask that this whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and free of sin. Let us commend ourselves and one another. A whole life to Christ our God.
Kyrie.
For your sanctification. Ότι σοι ο Αγιάς μας ημών και εσύ την δόξαν αναπέμπωμεν το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Αγίο Πνεύμα την ίν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Εν ειρήνη προέρθωμεν
του Κυρίου δεήθωμεν.
Κύριε λέησον, Κύριε λέησον, Πάτερ Αγίε ευλογήσον.
O Lord, bless those who praise you and sanctify those who trust in you, save your people and bless your inheritance. Protect the whole body of your church, sanctify those who love the beauty of your house. Glorify them and return by your divine power. Do not forsake us who put our hope in you. Grant peace to your world, to your churches, to the clergy, to those in public service, to our armed forces and to all your people. For every good and perfect gift is from above, coming from you, the Father of lights. And to you we give all glory, thanksgiving, worship, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and always and forever and ever.
Amen. Το όνομα Κυρίου ευλογημένον από του νυν και ως του αιώνα.
Το όνομα Κυρίου ευλογημένον από του νυν και ως του αιώνα.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε διδαξών με τα δικαιώματά σου των Αγίων ο χορός ευρε πηγήν τη ζωή και θύραν παραδείσου ευγω καγώ την οδόν δια της μετανοίας των απόλλωλος προβατών εγώ ημί. Ανακάλεσε με σωτήρ και σώσον με.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε διδαξών με τα δικαιώματά σου. Ανάπαυσον ο Θεός τους δούλους σου και κατάταξον αυτούς σε παραδείσο. Όπου χωρεί τον Αγίον Κύριε και οι δικαίοι εκλάμψου συνοσφωστήρε. Τους και κοιμημένους δούλους σου ανάποψου παρορών αυτών πάντα τα εγκλήματα.
Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit. The tri-brilliance of the Godhead singleness, let us praise, reverently chanting. Holy are you, the beginningless Father, co-beginningless Son, and Holy Spirit. Shine upon us who in faith worship you, and deliver us all from the eternal fire.
Χαίρεσαι μνή Θεόν τσαρκιτεκούσα εις πάντων σωτηρίαν, δις γένους των ανθρώπων εύρατο την σωτηρίαν, δια σου ευρημέν παράδεισον Θεοτό και αγνή ευλογημένη.
Αλληλούια, 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 δόξα σοι ο Θεός. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God. Ψυχάς των δούλων σου, σώτεραν άπαυσον, φύλα των αυτάσεις μακαρίαν ζωήν την παράση φιλάνθρωπε.
Εις την κατάπαυσήν σου, Κύριε, όπου πάντες οι Άγιοι σου αναπαύονται, παράπαυσον, Κύριε,
και τας ψυχάς των δούλων σου, ότι μόνος υπάρχεις αθάνατος.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. You are God who descended into Hades and ended the suffering of all who were in prison. O Savior, also rest the souls of these your servants.
Η Θεόν αφράστος κοίσασα, πρέσβευε υπέρ του ελέηθινε τας ψυχάς των δούλων σου.
Have mercy on us, O God, in your great goodness, we pray to you, hear us, and have mercy. Again we pray for the repose of the souls of God's servants, George and Athanasios departed this life for the forgiveness of their sins, whether deliberate or unintended. That the Lord God will establish their souls where the righteous dwell. God's mercy is the kingdom of heavens and the remission of their sins. Let us ask of Christ, our immortal King and God. Let us pray to the Lord.
O God of spirits and of all flesh, who has trampled down death, crushed the power of the devil, and granted life to this your world, do you yourself, O Lord, give rest to the souls of these your servants, George and Athanasios, who have fallen asleep in a place of light, a place of green pasture, a place of repose where there is no grief, sorrow, or mourning. Forgive every sin which they have committed in word or deed or thought, for you are a good God who loves mankind. For there is no one who lives and does not sin, only you are without sin, your righteousness and your everlasting righteousness, and your word is truth. Οτι σοι αναστάσεις εις ζωή και μακαρή ανάπαυσης των κεκειμένων δούλων σου Γεωργίου και Θανασίου, Χριστέ ο Θεός ημών και εσύ την δόξα να πέμπομεν, σοι του ανάξου Πατρί και το Παναγίου και καθόκης ο ποιός σου πνεύμα την ίνκη αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αιωνία σημνή με άξο μακάριστε και μνηστή αδελφοί ημών.
May your memory be eternal, our brother and sister, and may your memory be deemed worthy and remembered.
Αιωνία σημνή με άξο μακάριστη και αιμνίστη αδελφοί ημών.
Αιωνία σημνή
Ευλογία Κύριο και ελέος αυτού ευθυμαστή αυτού Θεία χάρη και ευλανθρωπία πάντοτε νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Δόξα Σύ ο Θεός ελπίσιμον Κύριε δόξα Σύ.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Αγίο Πνεύματι και νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων αμήν. Κύριε Λέησον, Κύριε Λέησον, Κύριε Λέησον, Πάτερ Άγιε ευλόγησον.
Ο Αναστάς εκ νεκρών Χριστός ο Λεθενός Θεός ημών, τες πρεσβείας της Παναχράντου και παραμόμου Αγίας αυτού Μητρός, δυνάμει του Τιμίου και Εζωπιού Σταυρού,
προστασίας του τυπερανίων δράμινου σωμάτων, ηγεσίας του τιμίου ενδόξου προφήτου, προδρόμου και βαπτιστού Ιωάννου, των Αγίων ενδόξων και πανεφήνων Αποστόλων, του Αγίης Πατέρων ημών μεγάλων ηλικών και μικρών διδασκάλων, του Αγίης Πατρός ημών Ιωάννου Αρχιεπισκόπου Κωνσταντινοπόλεως του Χρυσοστόμου, των Αγίων ενδόξων καλλιλίκων μαρτύρων, των Οσίων και Θεοφόρων Πατέρων ημών, των Αγίων και Δικαίων Θεοπατώρων Ιωακήμ και Άνιης, των εν Κρήτη δέκα μαρτύρων Αχμέτ, νεομάρτυρος και πάντων των Αγίων Ελίσσα και σώσε ημάς, ως αγαθός και φιλάνθρωπος και ελεήμων Θεός. Διευχών των Αγίων Πατέρων ημών, Κύριε Ιησού Χριστέ ο Θεός, ελέησον και σώσον ημάς. Αμήν. Κύριε, διάστε φυλάξε πάντες ημάς. Καλημέρα σας. Good morning to you.
Καλήν εσπέραν αρχόντες, αν είναι ορισμός σας Χριστού την Θείαν γέννησιν, να πω στ' αρχοντικός σας Χριστός γεννάτες ημέρων, Βηθλεέμ την πόλη μη ουρανία γαλώντε, χέρι ηχτήσεις όλοι εντός φιλαιότη κτέτε, ελφάτη των αλόγων ο βασιλεύς των ουρανών, των όρων πλήθος αγγέλων ψαλούσι, το δόξα εν υψίστης και του το αξιόν εστί, ή των ποιμένων πίστης εκ της Περσίας ερχόνται, τρεις μάγοι με τα δώρα άστρων λαμπρών τους οδηγεί, χωρίς να λείψει ώρα φτάσαντες εις Ιερουσαλήμ, με πόθον ερωτώσει που εγεννήθη ο Χριστός, να πάναν τον ευρώσει και εδώ που τραγουδήσαμε, να μη ραγίσει μίση κι αιώνικο κοκκύρης, του σπί του χρόνια πολλά να ζήσει. Καλήν εσπέραν αρχόνες, Χριστού την Θείαν γέννησιν, να πω στ' αρχοντικός σας.
Good morning. This morning we are going to conduct the oath of office for the new parish council members coming in and the ratification which we have received from the Metropolis of Chicago reads as follows. Dear Father Bakakos and members of the parish council, according to the documents which were submitted by the Board of Elections, we find that the parish council elections held on Sunday, December 6th, were properly conducted according to the UPR regulations of the Holy Archdiocese. Therefore, we confirm and ratify that the newly elected parish council members are hereby recognized and are recognized and validly elected and comprise the new parish council for
the years 2013-2014. And they are as follows, and as I read their names, I ask that they please come forward so that we can begin the oath of office. Diane Burbus, Tom Collis, Andrew Cannell, James LaCurtis, Chris Limperis, Dr. Peter Panton, Theodore Pappas, Tom Poulos, Dean Sarantis, Nicholas Mansour, Peter Spiropoulos, Dr. Stavroula Spiropoulos, Christopher Caprio, Rosemary Stewart, John Vasiliadis, Bill Vranis, and Jack Woods. Would you please come forward? I know there are some that are out of town, and they will receive their oath of office prior to the first council meeting in January. As I read the oath of office, you will reply, and of course I will say aye, and then you'll read your own name, and then we will continue with the oath of office. Please come forward and place your right hand on the gospel. I, your name, do solemnly affirm that I will uphold the dogmas, teachings, traditions, holy canons, discipline, worship, and moral principles of the Greek Orthodox Church, as well as the charter and regulations of the Greek Orthodox Archdiocese of America, and that I will fulfill faithfully and sincerely the duties and obligations required of a member of the parish council, so help me God. Okay. Immediately after the distribution of the Antídoto, we will meet together down in St. Catherine's meeting room, where elections will be conducted for your officers for the next 2 years. Congratulations.
Χριστός γεννάτε, δοξάσατε, Χριστός εξ ουρανών απαντήσατε, Χριστός επί γης υψώθητε, άσατε το Κύριο.
Please be aware of the announcements, which are basically the services for this coming week. There are a number of services in addition to just Christmas, Christmas Day. Tomorrow is the feast on the 24th of December, and there will be a service in the morning, which are the hours, as well as the Liturgy of Saint Basil the Great, and that will begin at 8:30 in the morning. Please also be aware that tomorrow evening at 5 p.m. there is a great Vesper service in anticipation of the Feast of Christmas, and that is the Vesper service. And as it says in your bulletin, communion is not administered at the Vesper service on Christmas Eve. However, on Christmas morning there will be communion, as well as on Christmas Eve morning and Christmas Day. The Orthros and the Divine Liturgy on Christmas Day is 8:30, and of course the liturgy at 10 a.m. We also have the Synaxis of the Theotokos on Wednesday, the 26th. The service times are the same, as well as St. Stephen, the first martyr, the deacon, and that is on the 27th of December. So there will be services each of the next 4 days. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Around this time of year, each year, between Thanksgiving and Christmas, we usually are inundated with many movies and stories about Christmas. And one of them that is usually brought out for our viewing pleasure to see is an old black and white film that speaks about people's lives and speaks about people's hearts. And I'm sure most of you are familiar with this movie. It's a film entitled It's a Wonderful Life. And it's a story about the life of a boy who would later grow into a mature man. His name was George Bailey. And in this heartwarming film, George felt that he never was given the opportunity to amount to much in life. And anytime he wanted to do something, circumstances prevented him. He had dreams of becoming a famous architect and traveling the world. But instead, he feels trapped in a boring job in a small, seemingly meaningless town. And then a crisis occurs that strains every fiber of his being, both heart and soul. And he is faced with unjust criminal charges. And although he has a fine family and many friends in the community, the injustice of the situation plunges him into despair. And so faced with this crisis, George Bailey breaks down, and he decides to end his life by jumping off of a bridge into a river. But that's when the movie really starts. And when his guardian angel, an older man by the name of Clarence, comes down to show him what his town, his community, would be like without him. And the angel takes him back through his life. And he shows George just how his job has benefited many families, how his little kindness and thoughtful acts have changed the lives of others, and how the ripples of George's love will spread throughout the world, helping to make it a better place. Now, I'm sure many of you have seen this movie, and the character George Bailey is played in the film by a very talented actor in his day, Jimmy Stewart. And in the making of the film, Stewart said that things happened to him that never happened in any other picture that he had ever made before. For one instance, in one scene, George Bailey, broken in despair, sits in a little roadside restaurant. And in this scene, Jimmy Stewart, playing George Bailey, raises his eyes, and following the script, he pleads. And he looks up and he says, "God, God, dear Father in heaven, I'm not a praying man, but if you're up there and you can hear me, show me the way. I'm at the end of my rope. Show me the way, God." And years later, in reflecting upon that movie in an interview, Stewart said, "As an actor, as I said those words, I felt that same loneliness, the hopelessness of people who had nowhere to turn, and my eyes filled with tears. And while I was making that film, I broke down sobbing. And that was not something that was planned to be put into the movie, but the power of that prayer and the realization that our Father in heaven is above to help the hopeless had reduced me to tears." I wonder how many people have been touched by this simple film. It's become a classic. And hope, my dear brothers and sisters, is what Christmas is all about. And that is what our scripture readings and chants speak about during this season of Advent. And as leads us up and we stand on the threshold in just a few days of the Feast of the Nativity of Christ and this beautiful celebration of Christmas. Because it's about hope. Hope in the birth of the Christ child. So as we stand at this doorstep on this, the Sunday before Christmas, the first thing that Christ coming into the world should mean to us is hope for the hopeless. The George Baileys of our world have a reason to go on because Christ has come into our world. And that is good news because likewise, sometimes you and I find ourselves to be in that situation of hopelessness as well. Sometimes our own hearts grow weary and our spirits sag. And we need to know that Christ is there when things look dark, even sometimes during the season of Christmas. There's a story that I'd like to share with you this morning about a woman, her name is Christine, who knew quite well what it meant to be sad at Christmas. Christine might normally be called a Christmas enthusiast, one of those delightful kind of people who take joy in the tiniest detail of the holiday. The Yuletide season is a time of excitement in her household. One year during a lighthearted moment, Christine decided to get her picture made with Santa and to give it as a humorous gift to her husband and her two grown sons. One afternoon at a nearby mall, she came across a Santa who was not, who wasn't busy at the moment with kids, and she asked him if she could sit next to him and have her picture made. And he seemed pleased by the idea, and Christine squeezed in next to him to have the photo taken. And then the congenial Mr. Claus turned to Christine and with the obligatory twinkle in his eye, asked her what she wanted for Christmas. And without giving her brain time to engage, Christine blurted out, "Santa, I'm going to have a hysterectomy next Wednesday, and I'd like a swift healing." For a moment, Charlene was mortified by her bluntness, how she just blurted that out. But Santa looked deep into her eyes and said, "I'll pray for you, and so will Mrs. Claus." Christine, moved by the sincerity, started to cry, and that was just what she needed to hear. As she walked away, she remarked, "You know, you still come to my house in the middle of the night every year, even though my baby is now 25 years old." And Santa, with a warm smile, said, "I know." What Charlene needed at that moment was the word of hope. And that is what she got. And she was fortunate to be able to encounter a Santa with a strong Christian faith who could give her a word of insurance in her time of need. Because that is what Christmas is all about. Hope to the hopeless. And secondly, Christmas time is about healing for the hurting. Listen to the words of the prophet Isaiah. "The desert and the parched land will be glad. The wilderness will rejoice and blossom. Like the crocus, it will burst into bloom. It will rejoice greatly and shout for joy. The glory of Lebanon will be given to it, the splendor of Carmel and Sharon. They will see the glory of the Lord, the splendor of our God. Strengthen the feeble hands, steady the knees that give way. Say to those with fearful hearts, be strong, do not fear, your God will come. And then will the eyes of the blind be opened and the ears of the deaf unstopped. Then will the lame leap like a deer and the mute tongue shout for joy. Water will gush forth in the wilderness and the streams in the desert. The burning sand will become a pool, the thirsty ground bubbling springs. And from these words of the prophet Isaiah, what a magnificent picture of the healing and a new life we are given to think about. It is the very thing that many people long for more than anything else, either for themselves or for someone they may love. There's another story I'd like to share with you. We know that cancer is one disease that all of us have had impacted upon our lives, either personally or been stricken with, or having a loved one, or knowing someone who has battled with this disease. There's a man named Mark, a big, burly man who owns two transmission repair shops here in the Chicago area. Last year, Mark's wife, Debbie, was diagnosed with ovarian cancer. And as Mark watched the woman he loved suffer, he tried to think of some way that he could help her. And finally, he realized that all he could do was to pray. And even then, he wasn't sure that that was going to be enough. So last spring, instead of advertisements for oil changes and brake specials, the signs at his place of business simply read, "Please pray for Debbie that the cancer will go away." Well, suddenly, streams of customers, many of them strangers, began stopping by to ask about Debbie and to offer their prayers. Mark also began personally asking customers and business colleagues to pray for his wife. People of every faith came by to offer their support. Some customers told Mark that they had not prayed in 20 years, but they would be praying for Debbie. And as the months passed, Mark noticed a change in his wife as well as in himself. He had become pretty cynical about the human race. Because after all, nobody likes to have their car worked on, and when a person would come there, they were usually very demanding or rude or grouchy or skeptical. Mark was tired of dealing with unhappy people all the time. But after he posted the sign about his wife's cancer, he was amazed by the outpouring of love and support from his customers, and even from total strangers. Well, a few days before Christmas, Debbie and Mike got the good news that her cancer was now in remission. And on Christmas Eve, Mark drove to the two shops and he posted a new sign. And it read, "Please God, we now praise you, for Debbie is winning her battle with cancer." My dear brothers and sisters, hope is what the season of Advent is all about. So often we forget it when we step out of these doors and we go into a world that is anything many times but Christian. But it is a time of hope and expectation for the new, the fresh, and the miracle that Christ has come to save us. Now we know certainly that not everybody, unfortunately, wins their battle with cancer. But we do know that Christ's will is for healing. He never withheld healing from anyone who asked it, the blind, the deaf, the physically challenged. So the coming of Christ for us this Christmas is for one of hope for the hopeless and healing for the hurting. And finally, there's one more thing. The coming of Christ is joy for all who believe. The prophet Isaiah writes, "And a highway will be there, and it will be called the way of holiness. No lion will be there, nor will any ferocious beast get up on it. They will not be found there. But only the redeemed will walk there, and the ransomed of the Lord will return. They will enter Zion with singing. Everlasting joy will crown their heads. Gladness and joy will overtake them, and sorrow and sighing will flee away. My dear friends, the coming of Jesus brings joy. For to be in his presence is to be in heaven. And there's a popular story about a wealthy man who found great joy in collecting fine art from all over the world. And this man had a son. The son also grew to enjoy just what his father loved, art. And they spent many pleasant years collecting famous paintings for their very well-off and huge mansion that they owned. But one day there was a war that broke out in their country, and the son went off to fight. And a few weeks before Christmas, the young man was reported missing in action. And the old man, the father, was filled with much anxiety as he waited to hear of his son's fate. And the news finally came. Only days before Christmas, the news arrived that the art collector's son was dead. The letter had said that his son died a hero, that he had been trying to help a fallen comrade when he himself had been shot. Well, the old man didn't think that he would survive this grief because he had loved his son more than life itself. He couldn't bring himself to celebrate Christmas. He barely felt alive. But there was a knock on the door that interrupted his moment of grief, and at the door stood a young soldier in the doorway who introduced himself as the man whose life had been saved by the old man's son. And he had come to express his appreciation and to give him a gift. And the soldier explained that he too was an artist, and he had painted a picture of the man's son. And the father was amazed by the lifelike quality of the painting. And so the father took it. Wasn't very good, but he loved that painting because it was a picture of his son. And he hung it on the mantle of his study. And there it brought him great comfort. And to his father, that became the prized work of art that he had in all of his house, more than any other in his vast collection. Well, after a few years, his father died, and other art collectors around the world were excited to learn of the old man's death because it meant that finally his collection would now be put up for sale. And the day of the auction, people crowded into the mansion, eagerly awaiting for the chance to be able to bid on some of these priceless artifacts. And a sigh of disappointment escaped the crowd when they realized that, per the old man's will, the picture of his son that this other soldier painted would be the first piece to be auctioned off. And the other collectors called out impatiently that they had come to bid on the real art, not some sentimental piece, and no one would step forward to make a bid. Finally, a friend of the family bid $10 for the painting. And this man had been fond of the son, and he knew how much this piece of art meant to the father. When his bid was accepted by the auctioneer, all the other collectors mockingly cheered, because now finally they would be able to get a chance to bid on the important stuff, on the expensive stuff. But the auctioneer put away his gavel and announced that the bidding had closed. And the collectors were furious. Was he crazy? All they'd sold was a worthless picture of the old man's son. What about the rest of the art? The auctioneer then pulled out a draft of the old man's will and said, "It's very simple. According to the will of the father, whoever takes the son gets it all." And that is what Advent is all about. God has revealed himself to mankind through his Son.
And now we know what God wants, a new human creation. And this is how it happens. When we take the Father's Son, we get it all. When we walk in the light of Christ's love, we carry His coming heavenly kingdom into our hearts. So even amidst the rush of our last-minute Christmas preparations, we need to realize the fruition of God's plan. As Orthodox Christians, that is the way believers feel in the presence of Jesus. His coming means hope for the hopeless, help for the hurting, and unutterable joy for those who call Him Lord. Because that is the true intent of Christmas and what Christmas is really all about. Christ has come into the world in the form of a tiny babe. No wonder we sing, "Joy to the world, the Lord is come." Amen. Sounds like his father.
Christos genate doxasate, Christos ex uranon apandisate, Christos επί γης υψώθητε, άσατε το Κύριον πάσα η γη και νεφροσύνη, ανυμνήσατε λαϊ ότι δε δόξα.
Πατρός γεννηθέντη αρέστος Υιό και επεσχάτων εκ Παρθένου σαρκωθέντη ασπόρος Χριστό το Θεό βοήσομεν ο ανυψώσας το κέρας ημών Άγιος η Κύριε.
Ράδος εκ της ρίζης Ιεσέ και άρθος εξ αυτής Χριστέ εκ της Παρθένου ανε βλαστησάς εξ όρος ο ενετός Θεός, ήλθε σαρκωθήσε ξαπειράντρου Άιλος και Θεός δόξα τη δύναμη σου Κύριε.
Νεύσον προς ύμνουσι και τον ευεργέτα εχθρού ταπεινών την επιρμένη νόφρη φέρονται πάντε πόπτα της αμαρτίας υπερθέν ακλόνητον εστηριγμένου μα καρμελόδο τη βάση της πίστεω.
Θεός ον ειρήνης πατήρ ικτυρμών
της μεγάλης βουλής σου των αγγελών ειρήνην παρεχόμενων απέστειλας ημίν. Όθεν θεογνωσίας προς φως οδηγηθέντες εκνυκτός ορθρίζοντες δοξολογούμεν σε φιλάνθρωπε.
Εκνυκτός εργώνες κοντισμένη πλάνη φιλασμόνιμη Χριστέ της εγρηγόρη συντελούς
ύμνον
ως ευεργέτη εδισπορίζον εγκαιρείτε την τρίβον καθήνα να τρέχονται ευρωμεν
σπλάχνον ιον αλεμβριον απίμεσεν εν αμοιωστήν ιον εδέξα του τι παρθένο δε ενικήσας ο λόγος και σάρκα σαν διάφθορον εις γαρούχοι πέστηρες την τεκούσαν κατέσχεν απήμαντο.
Νέον Ιωνας εν μοιχείς θαλατής ελθύνε δίτω και ζάλι να πάρκεσαι, νυγείς εγώ δε το τυραννούντος βέλη. Χριστέ προσαυδό των κακών ανερέτην, θα τον μολύνσε της εμείς ραθυμίας.
Και προστινούμεν τον Κύριον. Θαύματος υπερφύους ύδρος ο βόλος εξεικόνησε καμήνος τύπος. Γαλούσε δέξα το φλέγι νέου όσου δε πίρτης θεότητος παρθένουν είναι παιδινίδη. Δύο ανυμνούντες αναμέρψομεν ευλογητό ικτήσεις πάσα των τυριών. Υψούτο εις πάντας τους αιώνας.